If he tell you to click on the link, you click on the link. Right there.
Hi, this is Hadas from Mike in Canva, and in this tutorial I'd like to show you how I used DID's technology within Canva to create this pizza ad. So let's jump ahead and see exactly what I had to use. First of all, I've picked a video, opened up the editor, and started off by uploading an image that I've created in Midjourney. I created this grandmother, and now I went to photos and I searched for a pizza photo. Picked this one, and now I'm looking for some steam. I wanted a video that can create the effect of a pizza that has steams coming out of it. So this is the video. Let's just resize it for a while. I also searched for a speech bubble. This one, let's just flip it. And I added some text boxes. Now let's go ahead and start building this ad. So I'm going to click on this grandmother and I'm actually going to upload it to my DID account. So I'm just going to go to apps, click on DID, connect it with my DID account that I've created beforehand. And now I'm going to upload my presenter. So here's the grandma and I'm going to type in her text. Once I do that, I choose the language. Now I wanted her to have an Italian accent and I couldn't find one under English. So I just went ahead and picked Italian and it worked just fine. Now choose a voice. I choose Fabiola. You can preview the speech. It works fine. And I generated this for 1 credit. Now there she is. I can delete the original photo and I'm just going to drag and drop her into a frame. But before I do that, let's just put the pizza as a background. I'm just going to set it as a background and place it here. And now I'm going to drop this video inside a circle frame. Place it here, place the speech bubble, go to position, let's forward this, go to layers, adjust the placement, and there it is. Now the video. What I'm going to do is I'm going to resize this to the exact size of my canvas, stretch it all the way, and then I'm just going to give it some transparency. So I'm going to pull this down, let's say here. Yeah, that looks good, but the steams are just too much to the front. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate the pizza photo, or I'm just going to pick it all over again from my photos. And then I'm going to remove the background. This is a pro feature. So if you do not have pro, you can use my 45-day link in the comments below. And now once I've removed the background, I'm going to place it exactly on top of the original pizza. And then I'm going to go to position and place it behind the steams. Let's see what it looks like. Play it. Okay, looks good. Now I think I'm just going to resize again the steams. Just going to pull it up a little bit. Oops, need to resize the pizza again. Just a minute. Let me fix that. Okay, and now you see that it looks like my background is a bit darker. Let's just set this a bit lower and set the transparency to be lighter. Play around with this. I'll put it right here. Okay, since it's in the background, it's not going to cover anything. So I'll just go to position, place it again behind the second pizza and my granny. And there you see it looks fine. Don't worry about this border at the bottom. It's not going to show up. It's just when I preview this. Okay, now I'm just going to add some text and I'm going to add an animated sticker, this arrow that is going to point out that you need to click here. And now let's edit the video. So this granny is talking for too long. I need to split this video. And once I've split this video, what I want to do in the second part of the video is just replace her video talking with a still photo, just so I have a nice closure to this part. So I'm just going to replace it. I'm going to make it a lot shorter, and I'm going to add a transition so it'll be smooth when it changes from the talking avatar to the stills photo. So I'm just going to go to dissolve. I really like the dissolve transition, and I'm going to add some audio now. So I found this Apoco, which is really nice. I'm just going to set it from the beginning to the end, click on the audio, go to audio effects, set the fade out, and I'm going to set the volume to be really subtle, let's say around 10, so we can still hear the grandmother talking and the music in the background. And now let's go ahead and see what we did.
If you tell you to click on the link, you click on the link right there.
I love it. You're welcome to share your designs in the comments below, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye for now.